The original script of The Matrix, shown in the book, The Art of the Matrix, you can find different stories and alternate scenes from the original film. It was in this book where we found the deleted scene of Eddie, the possible predecessor of Neo, who died at the hands of Morpheus himself after being captured by Agent Smith. Today we will discuss two other scenes that were either changed or deleted from the film. What if the people in the real world ate insects to survive? Or what if the agents used special weapons to capture Morpheus? Welcome to Matrix Explained.
Welcome to the desert of the real.
One of the most famous scenes in the original film is when Neo dines on a protein paste for the first time.
It's a single-celled protein combined with synthetic aminos, vitamins, and minerals. Everything the body needs.
In the original script, there is an alternate version of this scene. Sit down, Neo. Let's get you something to eat. Piled onto plates are pieces of a large black-shelled creature. Everyone begins grabbing and cracking open shells, pulling out the meat, and dipping it into bowls of butter-flavored topping. So, Neo, how did you like the orientation program? He sucks at a long piece that looks a lot like a crab leg. It was effective. Neo struggles, trying to break open the shell. I created Eve, you know. Buzz laughs, and I can create anyone else if your heart desires. Buzz is our local porno shop. Don't listen to these prunes, Neo. We're men. We have urges. He leans close, licking the artificial butter from his lips. If you've ever fantasized about screwing any woman, or hell, any man, on disc, I already got Marilyn Monroe, Betty Page, Cookie Roberts. Oh, that brain. Jazz hands him a piece of white meat. Neo dips it and eats it. What is this? You're going to learn, Neo. There are some questions you don't want to know the answers to. Suddenly, the lights dim, and Tank, who left for a moment, returns carrying a small fruitcake with a single candle on it. Here's a little something we do, Neo, to celebrate your first day out. He raises his polyplastic glass. Everyone does the same. Happy birthday, Neo. Neo stares at the burning candle. Be careful what you wish for. Now the obvious first question that comes to mind is, what are they eating? In the final cut of the film, the crew eats some sort of artificial protein filled with vitamins and minerals, everything the body needs. The crew doesn't seem to enjoy it, but it's not like they can put some steaks on a grill. Steaks. Maybe that's why Cypher wanted to get back into the Matrix. Yet in this alternate scene, they seem to be dining on some sort of arthropod-like animal. The script describes one of the limbs as being similar to a crustacean, but it could be a giant roach for all we know. Neo did ask what it was, to which he was given a response of, "You don't want to know." Ignorance is bliss clip. Remember that the planet is suffering from climate pollution. So it does make sense that the species of animals that survived the war would be insects who have mutated into giant monsters. And there you have your source of protein. Dozer does explain in the film that what they are eating is a synthetic protein, but it could be blended insect guts for all we know. Another interesting change is in the names of some of the characters. Buzz, of course, is Mouse in the film, since he explained he designed the training program. And Jazz, who could be Dozer, since he is the one who told Neo that it's better for him not to know what he is eating. But the most interesting omission that should have been left in the film is the birthday celebration. Social rituals or gatherings, like birthday parties, are fundamental to the human condition. So it would make sense that they continue these kinds of celebrations in the real world. Furthermore, to celebrate Neo's awakening from the Matrix would also deepen his relationship with Morpheus and the crew. But unfortunately, the scene was cut. It's understandable, as it took away a bit of the mysticism or seriousness of the plot. Now in this deleted scene, we see Morpheus's capture play out differently. In it, Morpheus puts up more of a fight to buy Neo and the others time to escape. He sacrificed himself for the One. In the Art of the Matrix book, there are storyboards of how the scene was originally planned. Let's go ahead and read the information on these storyboards. The basic gist here is retained in the later version, with Morpheus sacrificing himself. Only in the film, the sacrifice occurs earlier, straight from the wet wall into the bedroom where he fights Agent Smith. This is a close-up of Neo's face as the cops scurry up behind Morpheus. Morpheus has no escape and is heading up towards a manhole to go to street level. This next bit was to be a much larger scale fight between Morpheus, the cops, and the agents. Morpheus is exploding out of the manhole cover into the streets, where he is surrounded by a zillion cops with guns turned on him. Here's a really cool idea that was dropped, where one of the agents comes up to Morpheus with a special gun. It's an idea that Larry and Andy had about a gun that fires tranquilizer needles, which was to work with compressed air. In the shot below, we see a close-up of the gun, and see all the little puffs escaping through the vents as the gun is fired. In the film, the agents used needles and syringes filled with a unique liquid designed specifically for red pills to make them talk. They also used conventional weapons, such as guns. So the idea that the agents are using guns that shoot tranquilizers makes a lot of sense. A weapon that seems a bit more futuristic, that is used exclusively against resistance members. While this idea was scrapped, maybe we will see it return in Matrix 4. Back to the storyboard. This scene only got better with Morpheus deflecting the little needles with the manhole cover, and then whipping the cover like a super huge discus. He nails the agent in the stomach, sending him flying back into the police truck. The truck was going to get knocked up onto two wheels from the incredible impact, windows exploding, the frame buckling like it's just been smashed by a speeding car. Larry and Andy had this all worked out, how they were going to do it. With wires and thin sheet metal, you can almost hear the shattering glass. Here's Morpheus kicking back, getting busy with the cops. This shot where all the cops jump on top of Morpheus evolved into the overhead shot with Agent Smith kicking his butt in the bathroom, where all the cops come in. This one is my own idea, the 69th throw as we called it. For some reason it didn't make it into the film. Without a doubt, this version of Morpheus's capture would have contributed much to his characterization. He was not so easily captured. He holds his own against dozens of cops, and a special weapon was necessary to try and bring this leader of the resistance down. This would have been one of the most exciting scenes of the movie. However, it does give Morpheus too much prominence. Plus, it takes away the meaning behind his sacrifice. If Morpheus sacrificed himself for Neo and is easily captured, then Neo would feel a deeper obligation or guilt to save him. In this storyboard, we do not see Morpheus the martyr. We see a leader who won't go down without a fight. Thus, this scene needed to be changed. There are many more alternate or deleted scenes in The Matrix, and we can't wait to analyze them. But do you agree? Should these scenes have remained in the film, or was it the right decision to remove them? For Matrix Explained, please leave a like and subscribe. And thank you for visiting the Desert of the Real.